In this video, we'll be discussing about types of bills in Indian Parliament. So there are mainly five types of bills. One is public bill, private bill, ordinary bill, money bill, and finance bill. So let's see each and every bill, the important facts, because it is commonly asked in prelims exams. So understanding, there are some minor differences only with each and every bill. So let's see one by one. First one is public bill. So public will be introduced by a parliament by a minister. So it was only introduced by a minister in parliament and reflects on policies of government, ruling party. So minister will be ruling party only. So and whatever bill will be according to the policies of the ruling party only or government. To introduce in house, 7-day notice is required. You have to see give 7-day notice for presenting it. So second one is the public bill. Also the from the name it's you can see that it is common policy. And second one is private bill. It is introduced by any member of parliament other than a minister. So private bill, you can see that there are mainly many questions came from private bill. It cannot be introduced by a minister, but it is introduced by any member of parliament. Reflects the stand of opposition party or on public matter. So another member of parliament can, which are not a minister, can introduce this. And the, according to what the opposition's mind, what it is going on, their policies will be come in mind. To introduce in house, 7-day notice period is required. So same as public bill, 7-day notice period is required for private bill also. So the third one will be ordinary bill, introduced in either in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. It can be introduced either in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, introduced by either by a minister or a private member. So we can see that public and private bill combined, this thing is came according to a minister and private member can be introduced. Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha is introduced, can be amended or rejected by the Rajya Sabha. So the amendment can be done by the Rajya Sabha or the bill can be rejected by Rajya Sabha. That means Rajya Sabha has more power on this particular ordinary bill. Can be detained by Rajya Sabha for a period of 6 months. So detain can be done by the Rajya Sabha. It can be rejected, approved or returned for consideration of president. So this can be done with another feature. Sent to president's assent only after being approved by both the houses. So it's only sent to president after approved by both the houses only, like lower house and upper house, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So let's go to the fourth type of bill, that is money bill. So most questions will be came from this area, that is money bill. It can be introduced in only in Lok Sabha. So it gives the Lok Sabha more power and introduced only by a minister. So it will be a ruling party minister will be doing this thing. And Rajya Sabha can detain maximum 14 days. Rajya Sabha can like detain this particular bill 14 days. But in case of ordinary bill, Rajya Sabha can be detained for 6 months. And can send to president's assent even if only Lok Sabha approved. It means Rajya Sabha even if rejects it, so it can still it can send and get approved. That is Lok Sabha's power here. Can be rejected or approved but cannot returned by president. So president has also some rules has to follow. He can either reject this or approve, but cannot return by president. President cannot return them for reconsideration or something. And another thing is can't be amended by rejected by Rajya Sabha. So money bill there is no power of Rajya Sabha, but in this thing ordinary bill it can be amended by the Rajya Sabha, like ordinary bill. Can be introduced only in the recommendation of the president. Okay, it's self-explanatory. Requires certification of speaker when transmitted to Rajya Sabha. So speaker must be certified when transmitted it to the Rajya Sabha. So let's go to the our final type of bill, that is finance bill. So it deals with the article 117. It comes under article 117. It contains any or all matters mentioned in article 110 along with matters of general election. So it will be basically based on article 110 and general election procedures. It can be only introduced in Lok Sabha. Okay, other things common to ordinary bill. So we have to see that other things, rest of the thing we can take from ordinary bill itself, and introduced only on recommendation of president. So conclusion, what we have studied is we have studied five types of bills which we used in Indian parliament. One is public bill, private bill, ordinary bill, money bill and finance bill. So if you give a close look to all of things, so there are some minor differences. By reading one or two times you can easily master this thing. So this is all about types of bill. Hope you understood this. And thank you so much for watching. Do subscribe to my channel.